Welcome back to FM Language. In this class, we will focus our attention on metaphorical manifestations of preposition AT. Metaphorical manifestations will convey meanings that are a bit more abstract and probably a bit more difficult to grasp, but I think that in the end we will be able to succeed in understanding what we are talking about here. So, which are the metaphorical meanings in question? Again, we will resort to the notion of targeting, and we will say that AT conveys targeting of an emotional nature. That is, it conveys either empathy or apathy. By empathetic targeting, we're thinking of instances such as he smiled at her, he smiled at her, where her would be the target, the empathetic target of the action of smiling. This is what is typically known as the positive connotation of a term or a word. So AT has a positive connotation. We have further specified that our positive connotation entails the notion of empathy. What about apathetic AT? Let us use this term, apathetic AT. By apathetic AT, what we mean is the conveyance, the expression of meanings such as the following. She was mad at her. Here, her is the object or target of somebody else's madness or anger. Another example is realized by the verb laugh. What if I say he laughed at her? Again, her is the object or target, apathetic object or target of somebody else's laughter. And what about glare in he glared at her, where glare is a way of looking at someone in an angry way. These are all sentences that express a negative connotation of particle AT. So what we typically call negative connotation has been like rephrased. We have coined the phrase apathetic AT to mean the expression of a negative connotation or a negative meaning, the expression of a negative emotion in the sentences that we have just used to illustrate our points. So what we here call apathetic AT is what is typically known as the negative connotation of particle or preposition AT. Last but not least, we would like to mention two important cases. AT is used in expressions such as look at me, where I am the target of your looking or regarding, or stare at me, where stare means look at someone for quite some time, for a long time. The person that is looking is also regarding the other person and construing the other person as his or her target. At this stage, I think it's important to recap some of the notions that we have been dealing with. In episode 1, we said that AT conveys the notion of targeting, and that such notion can be either literal or metaphorical. We said that temporal targeting is typically expressed in expressions such as at 7 o'clock. Spatial targeting is typically expressed in sentences such as at the park. Those two are the literal meanings of targeting AT. We have also stated, however, that there are metaphorical manifestations and that these express empathetic and apathetic, that is, emotional meanings of AT. More specifically, we talked about sentences such as she smiled at me, that's the empathetic use, and she glared at me, that's the apathetic use. We hope you have found this class interesting. If you have any questions or comments, you can write to us below. And please do not forget to like, subscribe to our channel, and share it with fellow students and colleagues. Bye-bye.